A young man has gone blind after only consuming fries, Pringles, potato chips, white bread, as well as processed meats such as ham and sausage. At 14 years old, he complained of tiredness, but doctors claimed he had a normal BMI and height, showing no visible signs of malnutrition. Doesn't this say something about our standards for what is healthy? I'm sure the poor kid walked into the doctor's office looking like a pale corpse, and they said he was okay because that's how everyone else looks in our state of malnutrition and ill health. After testing him, they discovered low vitamin B12 and anemia, treating him with B12 injections and offering dietary advice. You know, for what that's worth, they probably think that you can consume spinach to fix anemia. 1 year later, there were signs of hearing loss and vision symptoms, his vision worsening to the point of blindness by 17 years of age. Doctors again identifying vitamin B12 deficiency in addition to low copper, low selenium, high zinc levels, and reduced vitamin D3. At this stage, vision damage has been permanent. These doctors are claiming that vitamin B12 deficiency caused the issue, but it's unusual to hear about a vision loss pertaining to vitamin B12. Usually it's neurocognitive issues and motor learning problems. You know, despite the presence of some animal products in his diet, he did have elevated homocysteine levels, amino acids in the blood that become increased when you're not consuming enough animal foods. Elevated homocysteine always coincides with low vitamin B12. We see these elevated homocysteine levels in vegans, even vegetarians, despite them supplementing vitamin B12. This is because you need vitamin B12 to convert homocysteine to methionine in the blood, as well as other nutrients that are only found in animal foods. So if you're not consuming a high amount of very bioavailable animal nutrition in your diet, you're going to see elevated homocysteine. Elevated homocysteine is bad because it causes oxidative stress in the bloodstream, leading to all sorts of other issues. So there are definite concerns to a vitamin B12 deficiency, but most people with any understanding of nutrition would know the role of vitamin A in eye health. If vitamin B12 deficiency caused vision loss, we would see far more vegans having issues with their eyesight than we do now, especially considering vitamin A is known as retinol, specifically because it is contained in the retina of the eye. It's important to note that the retinol form of vitamin A is only contained in animal foods. Beta carotene in plants has to be converted, and some people can't make this conversion. The problem with low quality processed meat is its absence of vitamin A in this retinol form due to the poor quality of feed the animal was on. If the nutrients aren't in the grass, aren't in the animal's feed, it will not be contained in the flesh of the animal. Even low quality eggs, fish, and steak would have had small amounts of vitamin A. Unfortunately, sausages or processed meats made from pork would have had little to none. A lack of vitamin B12 can also increase the need for vitamin A in the body due to the constant levels of oxidative stress from elevated homocysteine. So not only is he consuming a diet deprived of these nutrients, you know, the nutrient deficiencies create a higher demand for other nutrients in the body, and it just keeps going and going until, you know, stuff like this happens. We can speculate all we want on what nutrients he was deficient in, what the solution is, but reality is that just about everyone on this planet is deficient in nutrients. Some people suffer to a more extreme extent as a result of, you know, environmental factors and genetic tolerance. The vitamins, minerals, elements, and fatty acids that humans need to function optimally are contained in quality animal foods, whether it be wild-caught fish, pasture-raised eggs, grass-fed beef, raw farm-raised dairy. These are the foods humans have thrived on for thousands of years. And the only people consuming these foods in America, in the UK, are those that are extremely health-conscious and aware of this. And there are still cultures and people throughout the world that have still maintained their indigenous diets to some degree and are therefore in good health. This scenario brings up the issue of modern food quality. The way we are raising our animals is not conducive to nutrient density, which is not conducive to our health. As a result of this, many of our foods are fortified. This isn't specific to white breads and cereals, which are commonly known as fortified foods, having a variety of vitamins and minerals added. We also see vitamin A and vitamin D added to milk. Normally, if cows are grazing on pasture, the milk will have a naturally high vitamin A and D content. Instead, we feed these cows soy, corn, crap, and then artificially add the nutrients back in. This isn't just about nutrients. It includes the mistreatment of animals, damage to the environment because of these agricultural methods, and the forms of nutrients added back in are usually synthetic plant extracts that are not effective and can actually harm us in some cases. Vitamin A palmitate being damaging to the liver and vitamin D2 causing adverse effects, whereas vitamin D3 is the naturally occurring form. Another issue with fortified foods is the addition of B vitamins, which causes them to stimulate your appetite. Normally, when consuming naturally made breads, like sourdough, that doesn't have these B vitamins added, they satisfy your hunger fairly quickly. But with the addition of B vitamins, these fortified breads stimulate your appetite, resulting in endless refined food consumption. If he wasn't consuming fortified processed grains, this young man would have likely satisfied his appetite for bread, for carbs, and then craved something else. Beer is an interesting example of this because it is very high in B vitamins as well as calories. It's why you see people chugging down pint after pint in a much higher volume than other alcohols. The young man also had high zinc levels. Zinc commonly being added to breakfast cereals, and high zinc can actually inhibit satiety hormones, causing a person to overeat more crappy junk foods. So a combination of low food quality and enrichment of grain foods has devastated this young man, and he will not be able to see for the rest of his life. This is why I am so strongly against conventional feedlot animals and why I promote wild quality animal foods. If animal products are raised properly and we prepare plant foods like our ancestors did, we will be happy, healthy, and thriving. Stop buying that high omega-6 soy-fed bacon at the supermarket and try to source local pasture-raised bacon. Don't buy that grain-fed ribeye every day. Go for some local grass-fed ground beef. Instead of having a croissant at the deli every morning, support a local bakery making artisanal bread from heirloom grains. Or even learn how to make it yourself if you consume grains on a regular basis. We have taken a step away from the food quality that existed in everyone's diet for thousands and thousands of years. In the past 100 years, refined processed foods, vegetable seed oils, poorly raised meat, fruits, and vegetables have made us a different species of humans. These issues are much more significant in countries like America, parts of Europe, China, but almost absent in Japan, Denmark, and various other countries. So we know that health and longevity can be achieved, but we have to take back control of our food supply. Thank you guys for joining me. If you could please like the video, subscribe, hit that bell icon. And guys, please, if you can, share the video with your friend if you enjoyed it. If you guys would like to support me further, definitely check out frankiesfreerangemeat.com. High quality, nutrient dense animal foods. We just got cod liver back in stock. We're gonna have Wagyu beef next week, beef belly in a few weeks as well. Really exciting stuff coming for you guys. You can also check out Frankie's Naturals, minimal ingredients, minimally processed hygiene and cosmetic products. I have a new moisturizing cream formula that I think you guys will really enjoy. If you'd like to reach out to me for one-on-one consultations pertaining to your overall health, send me an email, frankatofano@gmail.com.